Pain comes in all shapes and sizes, big and small, sharp and dull, then everything in between. But why? What actually is pain? And why do we feel it? Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
Picture this. You're just trying to play with your friends on the playground on a windy day when, boom! Out of nowhere, a big bushy branch cracks off a tree and barrels towards the ground, straight at your head. Whew, that was close. But you're not out of the woods yet. That's because a huge slobbery dog is off its leash and bounding right for you with fire in its eyes. Ah! But before the bark becomes a bite, the owner calls and the dog obeys. Whew, that was even closer. To celebrate avoiding not one, but two highly dangerous scenarios back to back, you're feeling like a million bucks and decide to hit the swings. But before you know it, all the adrenaline from all the excitement has you swinging a little too high until, wham! You fly off the swing at Mach 5 speeds, crashing to the ground in a heap with your pride bruised and your arm broken. Ouch! It might hurt a whole lot, but believe it or not, all that pain coursing through your broken arm is actually good for you. I know, it definitely doesn't feel like it, but that pain is one of the key ways your brain works to protect you. Say you put your hand too close to a flame and get a little burn. That first burst of pain gets you to notice that you're getting a burn. It hurts, so you move your hand away as quick as you can before the burn gets worse. And it's not just burns, bumps, and bruises. Pain can be the first sign that you're getting sick. Maybe you wake up with a headache or a sore throat. Maybe it's a red, runny nose. Without all those aches and pains, you might not even know you're getting sick. And the sooner you know, the sooner you can get started on the road to recovery. If you never felt pain in your arm after your epic tumble off the swings, then you might not even know the bone is broken. The pain keeps you from moving it around, giving the broken bone time to heal. Okay, so that's why we feel pain, but how exactly does pain work? What's happening inside our bodies whenever we feel pain? Well, anytime you damage your skin tissue, like from a cut, scrape, burn, or from a broken bone, it's almost instantly noticed by nerves in your skin. Nerves are a bit like wires that carry signals from one part of the body to another. When you get a break, cut, or burn, the nerves in your skin send signals up through your spinal cord to the brainstem and then into the brain. Then the brain takes all the info that it got from the nerves and analyzes it. Once the brain figures out what kind of injury it is, it'll send a message back to the spot that's in pain. That's the moment when you first start to feel pain and react. All of that message sending usually happens in a split second, which is why we usually feel pain instantly after an injury. Without those receptors sending messages to your brain, there wouldn't be any way to know you just broke your arm on the swing. Or at least not until you tried to use it. Of course, some things are so painful that it's hard to imagine how they could possibly be helpful or easy for your body to fix. So, what are some of the most physically painful things humans can experience? Well, things like really bad bruises, migraines, broken bones, and of course, childbirth are all well known to be quite agonizing. Bullet ants, for instance, have the most painful sting on the planet. It tops the Schmidt Sting Pain Index, a scale that rates how painful different stings are. Doctors group physical pain into three main types. Nociceptive pain is when your actual body tissues are damaged, like with a cut, burn, or broken bone. This type of pain can be sharp or throbbing and usually made worse by movement. Neuropathic pain is when there's a problem with the system that sends and receives pain messages, your nerves, spinal cord, or brain. most neuropathic pain is felt as a tingling, burning, shooting, or electrical sensation. Now, let's say your broken arm led to long-term nerve damage in your arm where the break happened. It's unlikely, but it can happen. In that case, you'd be feeling neuropathic pain. Psychogenic pain is when fear, depression, stress, or anxiety make a regular nociceptive or neuropathic pain feel way worse or last way longer than it normally should. Let's say you broke your arm right before the big championship game, and now you can't play. That might make you so upset that your arm can actually hurt worse. That would be considered psychogenic pain. Doctors also distinguish between acute pain and chronic pain. Acute pain doesn't last long, and it's usually a way for your body to warn you that something's wrong. As soon as the injury or disease that's causing the acute pain starts to heal, pain starts to go away too. By the time you're fully healed, acute pain will be completely gone. Chronic pain is a little different. This type of pain is called persistent pain because once it starts, it doesn't easily go away. Most chronic pain is caused when your pain receptors become too easily activated, making your brain feel like you're in pain even when there's no real reason for it. It can last months, years, or even a lifetime, and can be difficult for a doctor to treat. If you went flying off the swings, a doctor would classify your broken arm as acute nociceptive pain because the pain was a result of damaged bone tissue and you likely won't have any pain after it heals. So, why do we feel pain? It doesn't matter if it's a stubbed toe, childbirth, a bite from a bullet ant, or a broken arm. We all feel pain for the same reason, so that we know there's an issue. Without pain, we might not even notice something bad is happening to our bodies, and we wouldn't be nearly as quick to react. But when you're in pain, it's almost impossible to ignore. So while it's never pleasant to be in pain, just remember, it's an essential part of keeping you alive and well, even if it's sometimes hard to believe.